Welcome back, Ben. Markets holding comfortably in the green as we speak. The mid-cap index is well in the green, and the Nifty Bank as well has seen a good rally if you take it from Friday's lows. But let's get you some market opinion then from Harsha Upadhyay, the CIO equity at Kotak Mutual Fund, with his view on the markets as well as on a whole host of sectors.
We still consider this sector to be one of the sectors where things could further significantly go down. The inventory levels still are very high. While the stocks may show that they have fallen from the peak, maybe 30, 40, 50%, but the valuations have not really corrected. Even at these prices, the valuations are as high as what it was during the earlier bull run. So to that extent, I don't think there is a case for going overweight on auto sector at this point of time. Maybe the valuations will have to correct furthermore to really take that view. Rather than looking at sectoral themes, maybe it's time to look at stock-specific opportunities. There has been muted set of numbers for Nifty basket. It's hardly a positive growth for Nifty companies on a year-on-year basis. There has been some downgrade that's happening now. Most of the brokerages have been cutting their numbers. But I tend to believe that maybe the downgrades have to be a bit more than what's actually happening. There are pockets which are continuously seeing downgrades and are likely to see further downgrades as well. So our view is while the Nifty headline earnings or the valuations may not give you the complete picture, you will have to go a couple of steps downwards and see whether a particular stock makes sense to have it in the portfolio or not. We continue to have overweight position on insurance, both general as well as life insurance, and we believe that it's a multi-year call that we have taken. The capital goods segment is one where you will have relative safety, and the valuations today are not as high as what the consumption side of the economy is. So to that extent, I think the visibility is fine. Maybe we have order book for most of the companies for next 12 to 24 months. The valuations give a relative comfort. So for us, it's an overweight position, and continue to believe that once the economic activity starts to increase in our economy, this is one basket where things can turn around very sharply.
Okay, that is some market opinion which is coming through. Right now, let's get chatting with the management of Glaxo Pharmaceutical, GSK Pharma. They join us from the sidelines of the Motilal Oswal conference, which is currently underway. If you look at this way the stock has performed, it's down 20% since the start of the year. Annaswamy Vaidheesh, the president of South Asia and the India MD of the company, joins us now. Good afternoon, and thanks so much for joining in. On an adjusted basis, you have been sustaining roughly a 12% growth for the last two quarters. Is that the run rate we should expect even in the coming few quarters? And also walk us through the impact of the product rationalization and if that is going to continue.
Thank you. And as you rightly mentioned, in the last two quarters, what you are seeing is a trend. As you know, that we launched a program of focus, putting the energy where it matters. We have done a rationalization of our products. At the end of the day, in the pharmaceutical industry, having multiple brands can, you know, distract your energy. And as part of our accelerated growth strategy, we have focused on specific therapy areas. And so far, it's paying dividend, and we continue to believe that we should get the same similar kind of growth. That's the reason why we invested 30% more in the front line and reduced our headcount in the back end.
All right, Mr. Vaidheesh, you know, for the first quarter, it was near the double-digit growth odd. On an adjusted basis, it was around 12% odd. For the year, what kind of a number growth are you looking at? And in terms of margins, there's been a lot of focus in terms of cost rationalization as well. And that's what's led to some margin improvement. Going ahead as well, you believe the best is yet to come? Can the margins improve even further from here?
Yeah, see, the whole focus approach or the rationalization of product as well as the sales force rationalization. Objective is to improve profitability and take away what we call it as a unnecessary cost that are trapped in the system. And that's quite obviously it's paying dividends. And as I had said in the earlier various calls, that our aim is to move up about 20% EBITDA. And quite obviously, our aim is to beat our forecast. And we'll continue to grow faster than the market. That's our plan.
Okay. So you've achieved that. In Q1, your EBITDA margins were at 20.8%. So roughly from here on, they should sustain around this 20% band. If not, you'll do better.
Yeah, that's our aim. And we have a good plan in place to make sure that we continue to deliver that.
Okay. What about on your product rationalizations? The last few quarters, growth has been impacted on account of that. Will that continue even in the coming quarters? How long will it happen? Will it be through FY20? How many more products? What could be the revenue impact of the products which you're phasing out?
Well, the phasing out of the discontinued products probably will have till the second to third quarter. Some of them will spill out the third quarter, but you will start seeing it's washing out by the end of the year.
Okay, all right. Mr. Vaidheesh, if you could give us a brief number, how much of the overall business comes under price control, a rough number?
Approximately about 28 to 30%.
That's
a maximum that we have had.
Okay. Any new drug launches or vaccines that you're looking to launch?
Well, yes. We have launched a new drug for asthma, but particularly for a severe eosinophilic induced asthma. We have launched a product called Nucala. This is for the people who are really suffering from where there is no other option. This is the last line of option at this point of time. This is a monoclonal antibody, and we are getting a good response from the doctors, from the chest physicians, and the patients. And as far as the vaccine is concerned, we have launched Infantrix Exa, and we'll be looking at launching a couple of more vaccine by next year. They're all pretty interesting, and this will be leading the pack in the vaccine segment.
Well, you know, GSK Pharma had spoken to us a couple of months back, and they all had indicated that you all were likely to introduce your oncology portfolio in the future. Has that happened, or when will that happen?
Well, oncology platform is the focus of our parent company, and as and when we get a clearance as to how those portfolios are panning out on a global basis. And quite obviously, we are keen on looking at oncology portfolio, but it may not happen in the next 3 years because at the end of the day, they all have a long lead time for registrations and do the clinical trials. But as you know, GSK UK is significantly investing in that area.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and just one, getting back to this product rationalization, you said the phasing out of discontinued products will continue into Q2 and Q3. What will be the revenue impact in the coming two quarters on account of that?
Well, approximately overall discontinued products will have an impact to the extent of 80 to 100 crores on an annual basis on the top line. But from a bottom line point of view, they're all very low margin products. So to that extent, it will only have a positive impact. More we bring the product out of the portfolio, it will have a big impact on our profitability. So top line will be less, but bottom line is likely to have a good impact.
Much of it was in Q1, the impact on revenues?
Yeah, so on the quarter one, you know, probably about 20-25 crores, yeah.
Okay.
Okay, all right, Mr. Vaidheesh, thanks so much for stopping by and giving us all those details. Wishing you all the best for the remainder of this fiscal then. Well, getting back to the markets, I think we're still holding well in the green as we speak. So let's get a quick Nifty chart up for you on the screen. For majority of the trading session, we have been holding with gains of around 75 to around 90 points odd. And we continue to hold on to those gains. So pretty good going for the bulls, but the rest of Asia as well is trading well in the green. All those markets up anything between 0.5% to more than 1%. So the Asian market screen as well is actually pretty much green early this morning. All of them up. In fact, the Hang Seng is up 2.5% odd. The Shanghai market is up nearly around 2%. So in those terms, we were relative underperformers in today's trading session. Well, we'll slip into a short break. You come back, we'll get chatting with Vinod Karki, the head